Hello everyone, we are team 11. I am Chinmay and I am joined by Sahil and Ratna. We will be presenting our final course project for ECE 542, which is Advanced YOLO Frameworks for Kidney Detection. We chose this project because of the recent advances in deep learning, which have enabled numerous applications, especially in medical imaging. Rather than automating the decision-making process, it's safer and more feasible to automate repetitive tasks which medical professionals face. Organ localization is one such task, which can save a doctor's time by automatically detecting and localizing the organ of interest. Our goal is to develop an object detection model for the detection of kidneys from CT images. KITS, which stands for Kidney Tumor Segmentation Challenge, is an online-hosted challenge in which teams compete to develop segmentation models for kidneys. Segmentation is a more difficult task due to morphological heterogeneity in the CT scans. To constrain the scope of the project, we are converting the problem to an object detection problem using the given segmentation masks for calculating the bounding boxes.
Following the project description, let's understand what CT images are. CT, which stands for computational tomography, is a computerized X-ray imaging procedure that forms a 3D volume of data. The image on the right-hand side shows the various planes defined with respect to the human body. The dataset contains CT scans from 300 patients. However, only 210 CT scans have segmentation labels for the kidney and kidney tumors. The coordinates are used for training the model. The major challenge for this type of data is to process the volumetric data into several image slices used as data points in training our organ detection model. We further need to maintain the segmentation masks for each slice in the respective order and calculate the bounding boxes for further analysis. We are maintaining the image slices with 416 x 416 dimensions. We slice the 3D volume along the axial plane. The axial plane is highlighted in light green color and runs parallel to the ground if the patient is in a standing position. The image on the left shows one slice of the 3D volume, and the segmentation mask shows the location of the kidney and the tumor. The red color highlights the kidney and the blue color highlights the tumor. The slide shows the data visualizations of the kidney and tumor, where the overlaid image is the result of these both combined. The image on the right hand side shows the bounding boxes calculated using the segmentation masks. The bounding box coordinates are used to train the object detection model.
In this project, we are implementing the YOLO V3 model as our baseline to detect kidneys. YOLO V3 performs detection at three different spatial resolutions by predicting bounding boxes at three different locations in the network. It generates a final prediction using 1 cross 1 kernel and a depth of B into 5 plus C, where B is the number of bounding boxes, C is the number of classes, and 5 corresponds to center coordinates, width and height of bounding box, objectness score, and list of confidences for each class. YOLO V3 uses a class threshold to determine whether the predicted object is present or not. It also uses non-maxima suppression threshold to overcome the problem of detecting an object multiple times in an image. The backbone of YOLO V3 is a network of 53 convolutional layers. Each layer is followed by normalization layer and leaky ReLU activation. It also downsamples the images using convolution layer with stride 2 instead of pooling. This prevents the loss of low-level features. YOLO V3's backbone is first trained on ImageNet, and the entire object detection model has been pre-trained on MS COCO dataset. And these are the baseline results that we achieved.
We improve our results using the YOLO V5 architecture. YOLO V5 is conceptually similar to YOLO V3 with optimizations to training strategies. It uses the generalized IOU loss to train the bounding box predictions. We use image size of 512 by 512 and a backbone of 31 convolutional layers, followed by batch normalization and CVU activation. C3 block uses projections to lower filter sizes to reduce the size of the network while still maintaining the model performance. This figure shows our backbone model. We use three training strategies to train our models. First, we use plain model with weights transferred from MS Coco. Second, we use data augmentations using brightness and contrast enhancements. And third, we use spatial dropout to counter overfit.
The results table in this slide shows the performance of the three different models. The plain model, that is the YOLO V5 fine-tuned model, gives the MAP 0.5 score of 0.928 on validation set and 0.922 on test set. Similarly, for YOLO V5 model with augmentation gives the MAP 0.5 score of 0.929 on validation set and 0.923 on test set. The YOLO V5 model with spatial dropout gives the MAP 0.5 score of 0.92 for validation set and of 0.914 on test set. This slide shows the comparison of bounding boxes and its losses on training and validation data sets of all three models. This slide shows the comparison of object losses on training and validation data sets of all three models. The first two models show signs of overfitting and the one with spatial dropout doesn't. This slide and the next slide show the bounding box predictions using all the three models. This slide shows the performance of all implemented models, and YOLO V5 model trained using data augmentation outperforms all three models, including the baseline model. Thank you for watching our presentation.